We've come to learn that about trauma-informed design across many projects we get to work on, so hospitals, whether that's affordable housing or memorials. And our practice was really built on the foundation that design matters and that the built environment has a deep impact in people's lives. And as part of our broader mission, we believe that design is never neutral. It either can hurt or heal. And a core question we always tend to ask in our projects and from our partners is, how can the built environment shape behavior and move towards healing from everything from an individual level to a community scale? And using trauma-informed care and its principles and its lessons as a leading framework, we've also learned ways that space has the power to shape and influence our behavior, but it also plays a role in supporting individuals that are healing from traumatic experiences. And we've also found that trauma-informed design can be just much more than tactical interventions, which are very important, but it also provides us with an opportunity to address the systems in place, which Juliana was mentioning earlier, that those systems that continue to perpetuate trauma in the first place, this is a really great opportunity to address those at a higher level.